So I want to switch gears real quick. I want to talk about Rutgers. I love talking about Rutgers. They're celebrating their big anniversary, and not everybody's happy with Rutgers University, our state university, home to some of the highest paid state employees in New Jersey currently, if not in history. Matt Rooney, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning, Matt. How are you?
How are you, my friend?
I'm good. So, Matt, you're an attorney. You're the editor-in-chief of the Save Jersey blog, and you are a Rutgers alum.
I am. I have a law degree, which I think has served me well, but I don't always think the leadership of the Rutgers University system is serving its students well, especially since they're spending hundreds of millions of dollars a year in state aid.
Well, let me ask you this. Talk about this, how Robert Barchi is performing. And I've had some choice words for him over the past with what I think is terrible mismanagement from the professors and some of the outrageous things that come out. One professor that talked about the moral equivalence of ISIS, the overly politically correct atmosphere. You know, I think they want to have the gender neutral mascot. Like, there's just some nutty stuff coming out of Rutgers, and our tax dollars are paying for it.
Yeah, it's absolutely crazy, and I think the mismanagement up there goes pretty deep. A simple Google search will reveal quite a bit of it, but you're right. The political correctness has gone even more off the deep end under the current president's leadership. The latest story that we talked about yesterday at SaveJersey.com was how Richard Edwards, who's the chancellor,
right,
sent out an email celebrating the 250th birthday, which usually when you're celebrating somebody's birthday, you focus on saying nice things. He's announced that they're going to form some kind of committee or commission to investigate Rutgers' history of displacing Lenape Indians.
Wow.
And anybody who might have been a slaveholder that was somehow associated with this institution. You know, usually, Bill, again, when you go to a birthday party, you don't dig up 250-year-old skeletons. You focus on what's good about the university.
Right.
But that's how Rutgers is choosing to spend its time and our money.
Well, you know, it's a similar thing. We've heard this similar thread. If you could go back to the founding of our country and you could just focus on the fact that founders, that many of the founders were slave owners. And if you just focused on that and you ignored the fact that the founders were clearly, according to history, in their writings, in their own words, very conflicted over that. But if you paint with that broad brush and just say, look, the founding of America, we're gonna discredit the entire thing because of at the time what they were doing. It's a revisionist history that is selectively using certain facts. And I think it's unfortunate. I think it's a disservice to the kids that go there.
Well, that's exactly right, because you know what they would tell you they're doing is they're trying to create a more accurate picture of history. But really what they're doing is they're imposing their ideology on a new generation by only focusing on the negative things.
Can you tell me what is this safe zone? Explain that for anyone listening now, because I just want to understand it, that the kids require or demand or expect that they can be in a safe zone. Is that?
Well, that's right. So, you know, you go to a university because you expect that you're going to learn. You're going to be exposed to different viewpoints. You're going to grow as a person. But this latest trend that we're seeing now on liberal university campuses is that kids, these liberal students, expect that you're not going to challenge them, that they can set up a safe zone. They can hang out at a certain portion of the student union or in a particular classroom or set up some tents out on a lawn.
Right.
And no one can come and challenge them. And if you do, by the way, now we're finding they may try to file some kind of criminal charge against you.
Right, because so it could be hate speech now.
Right,
Matt? It could be hate speech if I disagree. All right, I got to take a break. Matt Rooney from the Save Jersey blog, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Lots more, I'm sure, will come up about Rutgers over time. You and I will be talking soon.